So number four has directions to decide whether the pair of lines are parallel, perpendicular, or neither. So what's going to tell us whether they are parallel, perpendicular, or neither is going to be their slope. So the slope of this one and the slope of this one. Okay, so let's talk about slope and the similarities and differences that are going to make them the type of lines that they are. So if the two slopes here in these two equations are both the exact same, then that means they are going to run parallel. Meaning on the graph, they're going to look like that. Now, if these two slopes are the exact opposite, meaning they are reciprocals, and they are opposite signs, so plus or minus, then they're going to be perpendicular. And on the graph, they're going to look like that. This is going to be a right angle. And then if they are not the same and they're not opposite exactly, then they're going to be neither. So let's go ahead and find the slope for these two equations. Now, let's take a look at the first equation. And in the first equation, we have 3x minus 6y equals negative 14. And this is in standard form. Okay. So standard form is really good for finding your x and y intercepts, but because we're not doing anything with intercepts here, it's useless to us. But we can take standard form and put it into slope-intercept form, which looks like this. Y equals mx plus b, where our m is our slope. So all we need to do to change standard form into slope-intercept form is to solve for the y. So in the first equation, the first thing I'm going to do is subtract 3x from both sides, leaving me with negative 6y equals negative 14 minus 3x. And then I'm going to divide by negative 6 on both sides, leaving me with y by itself equal to negative 14 minus 3x over negative 6. And then I'm going to split my denominator. So my y is going to equal negative 14 over negative 6 minus 3x over negative 6. And then I'm going to simplify as much as I can in each fraction. So my y is going to equal 7 over 3 plus 1x over 2. So from my negative 14 over negative 6, I was able to cancel out the negatives and then divide the numerator and the denominator by 2, leaving me with 7 over 3. And then in my negative 3x over negative 6, I was able to also cancel out the negatives and then divide the numerator and the denominator by 3, leaving me with 1x over 2. And then the final step is to switch these terms, because our x is in our last term and we want our x to be in our first term. So this is going to turn out to be y equals 1x over 2 plus 7 over 3. And our slope is going to be 1 over 2. All right, now let's take a look at the slope for our second equation. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to subtract 18x from both sides. That's going to leave me with 9y equals negative 17 minus 18x. Then I'm going to divide the 9 on both sides, leaving me with y equals negative 17 minus 18x over 9. Then I'm going to split my denominator. So this is going to make y equals negative 17 over 9 minus 18x over 9. And now I'm going to simplify each fraction as much as I can. I can't simplify negative 17 over 9, so I'm just going to rewrite that. But I can simplify negative 18x over 9, and that's going to simplify to negative 2x. You have the option of writing over 1 here, and I would always write over 1 and then rewrite it again as just the 2. But you have the option of doing either or. So then I am going to just switch these terms. So this is going to make y equals negative 2x over 1 minus 17 over 9. And our slope for this equation is negative 2 over 1. Okay, so our slopes are not the exact same, therefore they are not parallel. Our slopes are reciprocals. Remember, reciprocals mean that if they're a fraction, the fraction is just flipped. So 1 over 2 turns into 2 over 1, which is what we have here. So they are reciprocals, and they are the opposite sign, because the first one is positive and the second one is negative. So they're reciprocals and they are opposite signs, which means they are in fact perpendicular. So we would circle perpendicular, or we would write perpendicular, but these lines are perpendicular given their slopes and the fact that their slopes are reciprocals and opposite signs.